A short training regimen was added to help new generals familiarize themselves with the nukes, their capabilities, and their dangers. If you wish to acquaint yourself with their intricacies, you're welcome to approach the posters against the wall. If you'd rather jump right in, you may speak to any of our command terminals to move on to the next step in your personal nuclear arms race.
Greetings, General. Welcome to your nuclear launch training session. Over the course of the next four posters, you'll be taught everything you need to know about utilizing the Appalachian automated launch system. During your briefing, you should have been issued a nuclear keycard. During an actual launch, you will need to insert the card into the designated slot before entering your launch code, at which point the keycard will be consumed. Additional card drops will be brought in by automated convoy should the DEFCON rating continue to worsen. You may speak to your logistics officer as to the location of the pickup for your additional cards, should the circumstances arise.
And oh, have they arisen. This DEFCON rating the General speaks of has been pegged at its maximum for some time now, due to the hazardousness unleashed by our earlier guests. The silver lining of this is that one can often find a keycard convoy en route somewhere in Appalachia. We're happy to use our restored surveillance tools to help you track them. Access any of the surveillance system terminals to initiate your hunt.
Prevent misuse of Appalachia's automated missile silos, security measures for the region's nuclear arsenal have been increased well beyond any of our existing standards. Each silo has its own 8-digit launch code, which is valid for a single week. These codes are broken into 8 individual number letter pairs, each carried by a designated officer who is under strict orders to guard their code piece with their life. The order of numbers has been encrypted using a series of methods to prevent improper deployment. The bunker staff of specially trained code decryptors will provide the officer corps with the code when it is renewed each week.
The decryptors, it should come as no surprise, are dead. It will be up to you and your fellow members to decrypt each silo's launch code before they are regenerated. We, however, might be able to help. We've gathered all the information we could recover related to the codes and their encryption in the archives on this floor. It's also our belief that the flip card displays in this room had something to do with the code. What exactly, we leave up to you and your compatriots to uncover. And we're more than happy to use our surveillance systems to track down the last known locations of these code-bearing officers. Just approach any of our surveillance terminals.
The missile silos of Appalachia are equipped with an advanced robotic construction system, allowing them to rapidly refill their arsenals in a matter of hours. The silos themselves are defended by a robotic task force and staffed with a contingent of special clearance human missileers. Security protocols require all silo entrants, regardless of rank, be escorted by a missileer at all times. Entering a silo without escort will be treated as a hostile act.
We're unable to peer inside the silos themselves, but we are confident in saying we doubt any such escort still lives. You will be on your own once you're through the door.
advanced missile installations, there is a high chance of a retaliatory nuclear strike touching down somewhere in Appalachia. The intense radiation released by such a blast can have devastating effects on the local flora and fauna, mutating them into hideous monstrosities fit only for quick death.
To the contrary, General. Our memory banks suggest quite the opposite. Our previous residents managed to acquire samples of some materials created shortly after the first bombs fell, and what they found was illuminating, to say the least. Materials of exceptional versatility and volatility. However, if you can stabilize them fast enough, a jaunt into a blast zone, it seems, could be a productive one. Documentation related to these materials can be found in the archives. As well, the fissures that have cropped up around the region seem promising as possible sources of materials, along with some added pest control. The map in this room contains the locations of these fissures, if you're looking for a target. Now, with that out of the way, it's about time you got your hands dirty. There are a few key paths you should explore. Acquiring a nuclear key card, hunting down a few code officers, and delving into the nature of the launch code's encryption in our archives. Everything you need to get started, you should find in this space. How to proceed, though, we leave up to you. But please, feel free to ask our terminals if you have any questions. Good hunting, General.
Authorized access of secure transport container. Starting self-destruct countdown under dropkick protocol.
Thank you. surveyed burger box out in the ash heap. Those things are great for salvage, but you'll need to hit it hard and fast. The noise on the ships attract unwanted. So watch out. Good luck. Try not to get killed.
Silo Alpha. No one's here. Not even any military survivors. It might be for the best. I don't think Vault Tech asserting jurisdiction over the nukes would have gone over well. But it also means I'm locked out. Access is restricted to the highest ranking officers. It's not gonna be easy to fool. If we can't secure these sites, my God. The automated factory in the silo? Just how many nukes can it make?